Tra l'osteria e la campagna, life between the tavern and the land. The osteria have a humble and ancient origin. They can even be found in Pompeii. An inscription that can be found in one of its taverns states, Nihil durare potest tempore perpetuo. That is, nothing can last forever. True enough, though one could say that osteria have lasted a very long time. Indeed, the author of the graffito had found the walls of the osteria to be a forum for the public expression of aspects of his world, foreshadowing the role these places were to play in Italian societies. The osteria were considered exclusively dens of moral corruption, where one would drink excessively, meet with one's lover or even a client, and where hard-earned money could be squandered. Nevertheless, over the years, the osteria increasingly became a place where one could while away time after work, a centre where it was possible to congregate freely and as equals, where people would gather and celebrate with a glass of wine in hand, the ancient ritual of sharing beliefs. Here, one met to share comradeship, to retreat from the daily grind, where people could talk without fear of rebuke. The osteria was a place where opinions could be expressed in a no man's land environment, where there was no constraint or censorship. In them, one could hear poems written by the local bard, or one could witness various types of songs, ditties, jokes, some of them even risque and sprinkled with double meanings, and one could also hear famous opera pieces. By the first half of the 19th century, the osteria had become places of secret meetings for the proponents of an Italy free from Austrian domination and campaigning for the unification of the peninsula. By the end of the 19th century, they had become meeting places for political parties, trade unions, and where workers' mutual assistance groups formed. There, the workers passed from hand to hand political leaflets, and where they discussed interests in common and ideas of brotherhood and socialism. The osteria had come of age. So the tavern with graffiti that we left in Pompeii some 2,000 years ago had become the hearth for the creation of popular democratic cultures. This is the age-old voyage we would like to share with you tonight. Here we are in some little town in Italy in one of those osteria, sharing experiences with friends, eating, drinking, and singing. Let's enjoy ourselves.